It's one of the few things the Pennsylvania General Assembly must do that is actually required by the U.S. Constitution. In order to maintain the one-man, one-vote mandate of the U.S. Supreme Court, the State House and Senate must redraw legislative districts, both federal and state, to adjust for changing population trends in the state. On the federal level, the every 10-year reapportionment will mean that Pennsylvania will lose another congressional seat to a faster-growing state. In 2012, the Keystone State will go to 18 seats in the U.S. House, exactly half of what it was 100 years prior. It's not that the state's population has actually declined, it's just that we haven't kept pace with faster-growing states out west and down south. A new law redrawing Pennsylvania's 18 congressional districts must be passed by the General Assembly by the end of the year. The House State Government Committee has held three hearings on that issue. At the same time, state legislative boundaries, those of the State House and Senate, must also be redrawn to comply with a one-man, one-vote requirement. That job is being performed by the Legislative Reapportionment Commission, which includes all four leaders of the House and Senate and a fifth tie-breaking chairman. On the last day of October, that commission approved a preliminary plan redrawing state legislative districts.
At this point, we're in the public comment period. I have a link posted on my website, www.repcutler.com, where individuals can go. They can review the maps as well as post comments on how they feel that the process is going so far.
Passage of the plan will be followed by a 30-day review period during which citizens may file exceptions, and a public hearing will be held. The commission will then pass a final plan.